guys, Fugian Bro here. Gonna try to make this short and sweet, and sorry that I haven't made this video before. Just a lot of things have happened this last year, and just I really wanted to make it like actually earlier this year, last year. Just finally got around to it. Anyway, I want to talk about the Second Amendment. Why is it recently the Second Amendment is such a touchy subject? Why is it in question? And I also want to talk about, just a little bit, about people's misconceptions of what the past was. And a little bit of a history lesson for you guys. Okay, so people somehow think that our founding fathers, all they had was muskets and swords and that was it. And that our amendments on the Bill of Rights was created in 1776 when they had muskets and swords and all that crap. Well, wrong. No, we declare our independence from Britain in 1776. Correct. The actual Bill of Rights that have our amendments on them, the Bill of Rights was actually created, which has our amendments on it, you know, freedom of press, freedom of speech, freedom to bear arms, was actually created 1789, September 25th, 1789. Ratified December 15th, 1791. So why do I bring those numbers up? Some people like to think that, like I said before, all we had was muskets and swords and, you know, putting a ball in a musket and packing it down with powder and boop, 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 and shot. You know, 2 minutes later, you have a second shot, whatever. Well, that's not entirely true. In 1779, the Girandoni Rifle was created. That was before the Bill of Rights was finished. 1779. That's 12 years before the Bill of Rights was finished and put as law. 12 years. Okay. So why do I bring up this rifle? Well, this rifle was a repeating rifle. You could actually shoot 22 shots within 30 seconds from this rifle. The Girardelli rifle could actually hold 20 rounds in the magazine. It could also shoot up to 150 yards and go through a 1-inch plank. And it was a 46 caliber, similar to today's 45 caliber ACP. That's right. They actually had that back then. Well, you might say, well, maybe our founding fathers didn't even know about this rifle. No, Lewis and Clark actually had it on their expedition. I believe right now you can find this rifle at the NRA museum. So they had a gun, a rifle, that could hold 22 shots, or 20 shots actually, and they could fire all those 22 rounds in 30 seconds. So why is it some states you can't have a magazine that holds that much? Why are they looking at, you know, another assault weapons ban, the evil gun? I'm going to do more videos about assault weapons in the future. Because our kids are growing up thinking that ARs and AKs and all this stuff are assault weapons. They're not assault weapons. And I will prove that to you. But let's think about this. So people like Michael Moore that like to shovel crap and try to say that it's gold, say that, you know, they didn't have these type of repeating guns back then. Well, yes they did. It may not look exactly the same, but yes they did. that's not like a full auto gun, you know. That's, well, you know, that's semi-auto. Well, really. But the ARs and the AKs, AK-47s, are semi-auto guns. An AR-15, even its original design, is a semi-auto rifle. An AK-47 is a semi-auto rifle. The rifle made back then is a semi-auto rifle. So no putting a bullet in, locking it in, shooting, locking it in, shooting. No, none of that. It was all held in the magazine. 22 shots in 30 seconds. The Gatling gun was made in 1861, a mere 70 years after the Bill of Rights, and was used in the Civil War. Did they change the Bill of Rights? I mean, we had a Civil War. They had a chance of changing things during that time. The country was split in half. They had a chance to change things, to take out, they can only have this type of gun, but they can't have a Gatling gun. Gatling guns were around. No. The freedom to bear arms will not be infringed. They did have these things back then, just as we do today. They may have different names, they may look different, but all in all, they're about the same. I'll have more on this topic at a later point, and I'll have the links in the bottom to show you more information, to try to educate some of you on that these rights were put in place for a reason. Now, I know things have changed. I know we can't just have a revolution against the government. Or can we? No, I'm not calling for a revolution for the government, but the government is people. And those people control the military. The military is controlled by, of course, number one, the president, but then you get generals, admirals, and so on. All the way down to the lonely private. They're all people. They're all people of the United States. And when they signed an oath and took a vow, it was to uphold the Constitution. So think about that. It was informative. If anybody gets some information off this, that they can, you know, kind of open up the minds of their viewers, please take this information. You don't have to say that I originally said it, but if you could get the word out there, for you guys that have a lot more subscribers, get the word out there. People need to see that when these rights were made, we had the items that were the military was using. We had items that were repeating rifles and semi-auto rifles and full-auto Gatling guns and the such in that time period. So keep that in mind. Get this information out there, and people need to know what that our founding fathers, no, they didn't have a glow, they didn't have a magical lens to see the future. But they had items very similar to what we have today. Very similar. They knew about these items. They had these items while they were citing and making the Bill of Rights. It wasn't just muskets, it wasn't just swords, it wasn't just pitchforks. So please get this information out there. I'll have the links in the bottom of more information about the rifle and about our Bill of Rights. So some of you can actually learn a little bit of when things happen. This calling guns are evil is a relatively new thing for the last 100 years. It's pretty new when you look at the scheme of time. And it really hasn't gotten evil until like the 1980s. That's a very short amount of time. We need to swing things back around to the people. That's all I gotta say. Y'all take care.